Hey everyone, we're back with another Junos release. Here are the key features for 21.3R1. Use AF interface sensor support on JTI to export interface statistics from a Juniper device to an outside collector. Enable post-convergence path calculation on a device in a segment routing MPLS network to avoid microloops. We've increased the maximum reference bandwidth for ISIS and OSPF from 1 to 4 terabits per second. Configure the control word negotiation to maintain the sequence of packets between the label stack and the layer 2 payload for VPLS services. You can now use a discard interface to drop DDoS attack packets. Log those packets with a firewall filter configuration. Configure PCEP session management over IPv6 to establish a TCP connection between the PCC and the PCE. Integrate the passive optical network controller solution with our transceiver to instantly enable 10 gigabit Ethernet symmetrical access on the devices. Optimize traffic routing by using the bandwidth of both RSVP and segment routing links without notifying ISIS. For service providers whose networks are predominantly IPv6 without MPLS, configure static SRTE tunnels over an SRv6 data plane. Export the SRv6 topology information to the SDN controllers through BGP-LS extensions or an IGP domain. Perform RIOT operations on a QFX5210 switch using a Loopback AE port in a two-pass process. Use sFlow monitoring for EVPN-VXLAN traffic with IPv4 underlays. Here's what's new on the security side. Use APBR to apply application-specific rules to route traffic through designated paths, starting from the very first packet. Use network time security with NTP to secure your network time synchronization. You can securely transport encrypted Syslog messages from the control plane over TLS. Use Power Mode Express Path to enhance UDP and TCP firewall throughput performance. All right, thanks for tuning in. Be sure to head over to the tech library for more information about these key features and other release details.